Yo guys, welcome back to another tutorial. Now in this video, I'm gonna be teaching you how to transition without beat matching. All you'll need is your hot cues and just having good timing and just knowing the tracks that you're working with. So there's no beat matching involved, and this is kind of like a super simple way for you guys to transition from one track to another. And this is going from the drop into the buildup of the other track. So super simple. The two tracks that I'm gonna be using today, number one is Martin Garrix and Blinders Breach, and the second one is Skrillex and Habstrakt Chicken Soup. Basically, the overview of what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna have a cue point set at the break of my second track. So for the Skrillex and Habstrakt Chicken Soup, I'm gonna have a hot cue set up at the break of it, and then I'm just gonna be having both volume faders up for it, and then I'm going to just have my timing and do all that sort of jazz. So before we get into it, there's a couple things that you need to know. So when you're doing this technique, you need to have a track that doesn't really have any sort of continuation to the drop, or after the words, the drop, it kind of goes silent. So I'll show you what I mean by this. So in this track, the Martin Garrix and Blinders Breach, right when it gets to the end, as you can see on the waveform down here, there's really nothing happening except that sub impact at the end. And for around four bars, there's nothing happening. So that's the kind of tracks that you want to be looking out for. So I'll play what it sounds like. So as you guys can hear, there's no vocals playing, there's, you know, nothing, obviously. So that's the kind of track that you wanna have that you're gonna be mixing out of. Now, the reason for it is because if you do this simple trick and transition, when you have something that's being played after the drop, it won't work as well, and you'll need to kind of, you know, work around it, either echoing it out or filtering out the first track, which I can cover it in a future video if you guys want a simple way to transition from any track. But this is just one that you can use when you have an ending like that that doesn't really have anything. So basically, I'm gonna have my drop play out of my first track, of the Martin Garrix track, and then so if I go to my Skrillex and Habstrakt track, right here, I've set a cue point at where it starts, you know, the vocals of Chicken Soup. So I'll let you guys hear it out. Spice Girl in the coupe, so sick. Yeah, so I have it set right there. This is right after the intro, so. Spice Girl. So it's at that point right there where I set this hot cue. I'm just gonna be voicing over what I'm gonna be doing. So let's start the drop of the Martin Garrix track. So it has it playing out, and I have my volume fader up for this one, and my timing, and then I just filter out, decrease the volume, and that's it. I'll show you guys quickly again. Yeah, super simple. You guys can use it with basically, you know, any house tracks, dubstep tracks, any tech house and stuff like that, that are in the same key and that have that sort of empty area after the drop, which a lot of the tracks do. Some don't, but if you guys want me to cover a more advanced tutorial where I can transition, use this technique, but in, you know, more tracks that don't really have this sort of ending that you can transition into a whole bunch of others, let me know and I'll get started on that video. But in this case, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Super quick tutorial. Make sure you guys like, subscribe, and let me know what other videos you guys want to see in the future. But yeah, peace.